Hey guys, happy new year. Even though I haven't taken down all my decorations from Christmas, I wanted to show you how I take care of my orchids. So let me show you. So as you can see here, I have most of my orchids and some other plants that I'm watering. But first thing that I wanted to show you is that I water my plants once a week, or at least I try. During the winter times, it's not so crazy that I have to do it every week, but I try to keep a schedule. So all I do is, usually my containers don't have a draining hole. So what I'll do is I'll just put water, soak the orchid in water, and just let it sit there for about an hour or two the most. And it'll soak up all of the moisture in the roots that are here inside the pot. The aerial roots usually don't absorb it. Sometimes I put a little watering container with water so that I can get them in there so that they can also soak some water, but it's not crucial. Then the other thing that I do, and I do that for each one of them, then I just take them out of the water in the sink, and I drain all the water, and then I just put them back in, making sure that all of the water is out. The next thing that I wanted to show you is that it's January, and usually here in my area, we have the flowers coming in. So we have these beautiful stems with flowers coming, as you can see. So it's very important that you train the stem once you see that it's growing about maybe a couple of inches. You put a stick. They usually have a stick when you buy them in the store, and they have the clips. And so what you're gonna do is start securing the stem to the stick, kind of like put the stick upward in a very vertical position so that it won't go sideways. Sometimes you can do it, sometimes it's not possible. For example, this one over here is kind of like lopsided. So I had to go this way, but I'm trying to train it up vertically. This one was my most successful one to date because I was able to start training it all the way so that it is very, very vertical. So as you can see, the blooms, oops, I don't want to disturb the blooms, but they're so beautiful. I think these are going to be colored. They might be like a little purple, green purple, I think these are. And then these other ones here, you can see here, oh, my pasta's ready. You can see right here, guys, that we have a stem coming down here. And you see this one? So what I'll need to do is try to figure out a way to get it up from the underneath the leaves and get it to stay upright and put a stick somewhere around here. Okay, let me go see the pasta. And then last but not least, you're gonna groom your orchids every month or two. Just check for the roots. For example, this root over here, as you can tell, it's already dried. So what I like to do is go in with some scissors. These are not the best. These are like from the dollar store, but they've been working for me, and they're the inside indoor house plant scissors. And so all I have to do is go as close as possible to where the root is, where it comes from, and just cut. And all of this, don't be worried, because they're all already dried out, really. So you're gonna get rid of all of those. It's gonna give the plant space to feel a little bit more free, and it'll look better as well. And then another thing that I wanted to tell you is, for example, since you're grooming your plants, you're gonna be looking at the leaves. These leaves here look like they are about to go, so I'm just gonna let them dry out completely. And once they dry out completely, they're just gonna fall off. So there's no need to like pluck it or touch it or nothing like that. Just let it be, let it fall on its own. And it's a natural thing that happens to plants. They're gonna lose their leaves. You're gonna see more growth on top, and that's gonna show you that it's a healthy plant. Like this one's a little tiny one that is growing, so I know that it's still growing, it's still going. This one too, even though it's giving me so many orchids during the year and it hasn't stopped blooming, this one, let me just show you here. Look at this, isn't that incredible? So I don't have the heart to cut it yet, but I know that if I do, I would have like a nice beautiful bloom stalk coming, but I just want to keep it going to see how long it keeps going for. And then another thing, lastly, is just if you see the leaf here, it's very dusty, super dusty. So I get a paper towel and I put some water on it, wring it, and then I'm just gonna go very delicately cleaning the leaves. Another thing that this will do is once you do your watering, you're gonna see if any water pools inside here, and then you'll just take care of that by patting your paper towel there, and it'll absorb the water. So you don't want any water pooling in the crown, which is right there, because then your crown and your plant will rot. All right, that's it for this video. Do comment below if this helps you with your orchids, and don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe. It helps me out a lot. See you in the next one. And before we go, I just want to wish you all the health, all the love, and all the blessings from God for this year 2022. Take care. Bye-bye.